in the future.
I love.
Yep.
This is an early 80s mini, like Austin Mini, Morris Mini, Leyland Mini bootlid. It's off one of the last ones that they made in that shape. It belongs to my paint technician, Gail, and so I'm helping her out. Short story, was parked in front of the shop where she works, the paint wholesalers, and on a really windy day, their plate glass window blew out, and her car was covered in big shards of glass, and it's left a lot of dents and gouges in her car, so I'm going to help her out and take the dents out for her. And she's a tradesman painter, so she can do the spray work. Yeah, it's cool because it's her car, so she can do that. So we've had a look at a previous repair. We've stripped this back with paint stripper. Come and have a look at this. And the last guy that did her a favour, didn't do her any favours, as he just bogged this rusty edge here, just tapped it in and filled it with polyester filler. So we thought, let's see what's happening. So take it off on this side as well, where he bogged, and you can now see that the rust is also right under this lip, and he's just picked that up and stuck all that bog in there, which is really disappointing, but I guess for him it was the cheapest and easiest repair at the time. The problem for me is today I was going to demonstrate making a patch with an edge that you hold and hammer over, but now I'm also, not complaining, but now I'm also having to look at making an inner edge as well, or an inner lip to go on the frame of this, which the skin can hammer onto, because that's all rusted out as well. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to pop inside on my computer and have a look at New Zealand equivalent of eBay, which is called TradeMe, and see what's available in a secondhand door skin and a secondhand boot lip, because this is full of dents. We're going to have to epoxy urethane primer, bog it, and do the patch the rust here. If I can find an original one that hasn't been got at and has less rust or no rust in it, then for whatever sum of money, we'll do the budget and work out, because these parts are reasonably available still. So that's what we'll do. We'll go and have a look on TradeMe. This is the eBay equivalent here in New Zealand. eBay never bothered coming here and taking the market off these guys. It's quite strong. So as always, when I go on here, I'm just looking at cars or car parts. So here's the listings under the search words, Mini Bootlid. There's always a lesson in life. Here's one of my first options. It's pretty old and beat up. And of course, they've been honest and said that the bottom edge has got rust in it. And I think, well, that's cool. So it's the one I've got in the garage. This guy here, I recognize his workshop. I once built a fast mini road car myself and bought a lot of parts off him. So he may or may not have one. That's just under the title of car panels or mini guards and other parts available. So doesn't take me straight to the solution. This guy here says his boot lid's got no rust and no dents in it. But if you want to have a look, even on the internet, you don't have to get in your car and go and look. There's a great big thick bogged edge on the bottom of the boot lid. And of course the number plate holes are in the wrong place for the car that I've got. So straight away that says to me, hey, I might be wasting my time, or it could take some time to get a good one, because already here's two secondhand boot lids, and both of them, the first one and this one, have had the bottom edge rust out. So it might be your lucky day, Restolad fans, because I'll probably now film the fabrication and replacing of the skin and the inside edge.
Ready? We're recording.
Are we? Okay. I've set just the blank patch on here that I've put my curve in, or taken the bow and twist out, so it follows nicely. I've set it on the edge where I think it's going to go. It's not critical just yet, as long as I've got enough material to cover all of the rust. Because this has got the curve end on it, it doesn't go to a right angle corner. It goes to a curve. You can see the 10mm edge I've marked here. Follows this inside edge. And what we'll do is we'll mark that now. So it's exactly the same contour as this radius. I'm happy with that. These are the ultimate, man. Just on and off in a jiffy. I love it. And my paintable spoon grips. We'll sit down here now at my marking bench, because I like sitting down when I'm marking things out. And on that radius now, I need that, what have we got? A 10mm, 6mm? I think it reduces, doesn't it? It does. It drops to a 6mm edge and then tapers back out again. So what I'll do is on the, it just makes that easier to fold around that corner, right where I think about the center of that arc is, which is here, I'm going to mark 6mm. Not too dark, I hope you guys can see this. So it's 6mm there, and that should curve back out to the 10mm. I'm going to put another 6mm in here. You'll see how I make this all come together in a second with this little fancy tech drawing tool. And with 6mm there, looking at that panel and checking, it's a gradual radius out, so I'm happy with that. What I'm going to do now, this is called a flexi curve, and this one's all bowed and broken. So in my old sheet metal toolbox, having both trades, and scooting around on my office chair because it's comfortable. You get out a brand new one, flexi curve, and I'm going to make this from the outside of that 10mm edge, hopefully. I'll do it on an inside radius. You guys are all looking here in the dark. We're going to progress that into those 6mm marks. And a bit of freestyling come out the other side. Freehand drawing. So there's tapering into 6mm. If we measure to make sure I've got that right. There's my ruler. If we say from the bottom of the panel, we're coming up a whole 50mm and it's still 6mm here. I know this is getting a bit technical, but if I measure up 50mm from where it starts, it's still 6mm on that axis line there if we drew a right angle across there. So I'm still into 6mm, so that's going to match up there nicely. So I'll cut around that, we'll come back. Another rust lesson on this mini boot lid. Short story. I've replaced half the skin here, the other half I thought I'd have a go at brazing up, which seems to have gone very well with silicon bronze here. The rest of this doesn't seem too rusty, but the frame, inside frame, was a problem. Here it was here, tucked under the skin, or the edge of that skin, and I went to braze it and it just all blew out at me. I couldn't really fill those rust holes with silicon bronze. It's just got a whole lot of really bad rust and some kind of thick, gooey rust kill or rust sealer, so that's no good to me. I had to cut it out. Use these edge lifters. I don't want to give too much away, but I actually made these out of a pair of nail pincers. If you come and have a look, welded this piece of flat bar across here and just reprofiled this edge out of a pair of pincers and took the leading edges off there. It could be a lesson. The best tools ever are the ones you make. So all you do is sit that up against that edge and you squeeze it in, and it just quietly and gently lifts that edge up, as you can see it's doing right now. And then you just keep going a little bit further and further with each bite. So you squeeze it in further and further and further to the point where you can just squeeze it right up and quietly roll it back all the way along. That way you can unpick an edge and get to it to repair the frame or take the skin off if you need to put the skin back on, which is a really big job. You don't really want to go there. Here's my patch. Cut this to length. Here's the trick I want to show you guys today. What I want to do, this one here, when I replace this inside edge, you can see the weld. I have just welded it flat right through there, right under there. This time, I'm going to fold it up, put a small fold on it, and then fuse that on just under those holes with my TIG welder, and then when the rubber goes back on the boot lid, you won't actually see the joint. But here's the problem. It's got a slight curve in it, and you can't fold 3mm. All I'm looking for is around 3 to 5mm upfold. So what you've got to do to get around that is fold a bigger edge. I'm now going to fold a 10mm, which will allow it to fold in my folders, and then in my shrinker, my stretcher shrinker, I'm able to pull a slight curve in it to match that. You're sick of me talking, let's just do it, eh? In we go. I'm going to fold this on the 10mm mark. This is boring, you're not going to learn much here. But like Jamie Oliver, he still has to cut the carrots before he can make the main meal. So we'll squeeze that puppy up. Fold that right angle, 10mm, but I have all intentions of cutting that down to 5mm. There's no way this will fold 5mm. You can also do this at home. I've shown you in the previous lesson that you can use your, where's my bin? Oh, here's my bin. You can use your homemade folders and just hammer that over like that with your angle iron. don't have to have a set of folders like me. It just makes life faster and easier. Now you see, that's going to sit in there, butt up in there, but I don't want that much material on there, but I need it to fold it. I need it to put a curve in it, which I'm going to do right now. My shrinker. Again, just going to pull it around real quietly, because it's such a gradual curve. You don't have to buy one of these machines either. You could actually pucker and hot shrink, but that's another lesson for another day, which is how we used to do it in the old days before people invented these, or your boss wasn't so tight that he went and brought the panel shop one for everybody to use. That'll now sit in there. See, it's got a little bit too much curve in it now. But that's great. That's a good thing. Slightly pull that back. Or just change the jaws, and I'll use the stretcher to push it up. So now that goes in there. Oh, look, that's close. That follows that curve. So now I don't need the 10 mil because I only want to weld it on here on the 3 mil or the 5 mil mark to sit just under those holes. So it's all nice and tight, nice and snug. Just the way I want to work. You could weld it on there and then redraw those holes and use the boot rubber to hide it. But that's not how I operate. So now I'm going to grab that. Grab my tin snips. You'll get bored watching me. And I'm going to cut that off at the 5 mil mark. And just throw that piece of steel away. That'll do for now. I'll show you how to weld it, fit it in a minute. I reckon I'm ready. I spent a fair bit of time just shaping and trying to get this to fit as snug as it could. So this isn't quite square, but it matches the other inside edge that I replaced. It's just gonna drop in here like that, all beautiful, hopefully. Yep, that'll cross over there. I'll grip it down tight onto the outside skin. Like that. Come in with my tick torch. Got a bit of wire just in case. Yep, that's actually welding wire. Got low amps, it's gonna go in here and try and fuse that. So I wanna run this just below those holes, which means the boot rubber goes back on and it's hidden by the rubber. There's no having to bog it up or hide it from anybody. Pick it. Ta-da, an earth clamp. Here we go. Sweet. Fuse tack there. Sometimes you might have to just tap it in as you go. Don't be tempted just to tack it where it's touching. Try and work your way along. It's good practice and it means you can maneuver it as you go. I'm going to use a nice thin flat drift and just quietly try and close up the gap on the patch. It's like fitting up for my sheet metal days. If you can't, then just put a tack on it with a bit of wire. There we go, this guy's my tungsten. And while it's still warm, you can just give it a tap and close that gap right up. Like I said, my goal here is to try and fuse it. Not use filler wire, it just makes it faster and tidier. But sometimes in life, you just gotta go with the flow. So do a couple more tacks, I won't bore you with it, and I'll show you the finished product when it's all welded. Pick it. Ta-da, an earth clamp. Here we go. Sweet. Fuse tack there. Sometimes you might have to just tap it in as you go. Don't be tempted just to tack it where it's touching. Try and work your way along. It's good practice and it means you can maneuver it as you go. I'm going to use a nice thin flat drift and just quietly try and close up the gap on the patch. It's like fitting up for my sheet metal days. If you can't, then just put a tack on it with a bit of wire. There we go, this guy's my tungsten. And while it's still warm, you can just give it a tap and close that gap right up. Like I said, my goal here is to try and fuse it. Not use filler wire, it just makes it faster and tidier. But sometimes in life, you just gotta go with the flow. So do a couple more tacks, I won't bore you with it, and I'll show you the finished product when it's all welded. So here it is. The welding, the fitting of the patches is finished. Here's the big patch on the outside. It's given me no end of trouble, but I expected that. It's all hidden by the frame. I've had to hot shrink this back into shape because someone had bashed it in and bogged it in the first place. I've welded up where I've cut right through so I could also replace the frame. You can see it here, come in close. You can see it here, this one's now finished, exactly my goal for this lesson. I've been able to fuse some of that. Some of it I've had to add wire. Gonna go through and just knock the top off that, make it reasonably flush. I'll just sand it with my disc sander, and then I'll be able to prime that up and give it to my car painter or the laddie that owns it. So that's the inside edge. Hammered that skin back over. Gonna have to get the profile right. Gonna carefully disc it all up, make it nice and smooth, see if it fits the hole, then epoxy urethane, prime the whole thing, and put a skim of polyester filler or bog or Bondo over those welds and the dents that I can't get at in the framework. Job done. I might film that, I might not. There's a boot lid, skin replacement or section of skin, and inside frame. Two ways to do. You could have butted or joined the frame. The two lessons I'll try and put together for you, or examples. That'll do for today.